माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू अनदर सेशन ऑफ ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट पेपर. वी आर इन द वे ऑफ डिस्कसिंग जॉब एनालिसिस एंड डिज़ाइन, पर्टिकुलरली इन चैप्टर 3, और यू मे कॉल इट एज मॉड्यूल 3, अंडर द सेशन 28. Taken according to the syllabus, that is the topic on techniques of job analysis. This is also one of the best concept or content under human resource management that we have to study, because without having proper techniques, I don't think so that job analysis could be better which will implement there in the company and in an organization as well. So these are all the techniques that in the first slide I have pointed out. The details I will explain in my words, using of many references books. There are four techniques in job design are discussed below. Number one is job rotation, number two is job enlargement, and then number three is job enrichment, and then last one is work design. Now these are all the four techniques of job analysis that we find. There are other techniques are also there in job design, but from the point of view of the having restriction of the content, particularly in the syllabus of human resource management, that too in the purview of Goenka University syllabus. So I stick on to the only four techniques of job analysis. Number one, let me discuss and then explain in detail what is all about job rotation. It is one of the most important techniques of job design. An employee who has been doing the same job repeatedly over the years would get bored, and this would affect his performance. Job rotation enhances the employee motivation by periodically assigning the employee to alternative jobs. This would have benefits for the both organization and to the employee as well. See, this is one factor that I have to highlight, because if that employee is working altogether from recruitment to his retirement age, I don't think so that the level of production may increase, because once we change the nature of work to that employee, automatically the strength of that organization may increase. At the same time, the motivation will brought up by that employee, he will not get boredom, he will do the honest and then dedicate work to that organization. This is only through job rotation. The employee would be relieved from a monotonous cycle, and the organization would benefit from his motivated performance. During job rotation, the employee will also gain a wider knowledge of the organization and its work process. Job rotation also helps managers to deal with frequent absenteeism and high turnover of workforce. This is also one important aspect, that if we are not having job rotation, the employee is not going to get such types of knowledge which actually the organization will requires. If the same job will continue, the employee may give reason of his personal, and also he will frequently get absent to the organization. In turn, which will affect the workforce of that organization. Knowledgeable employees can fill in for absent works, and work routines will not be affected. It is also an effective technique of training new inexperienced employees. Job rotation also helps to developing management generalists at higher level organization, as it exposes them several different operations. This is what the one of the finest and then foremost important technique of job analysis is concerned. The second one is job enlargement. Job enlargement involves increasing the length and hence the operating time of each cycle of work for the job holder. Basically, different and continuous small cycle would be integrated into one single cycle of operation. This would reduce the number of repetitions of the operating cycle and increase the scope of work for that employee. See, this is how the cycle, the chain cycle will work it out to make an integration in that single cycle operation, particularly when there is an enlargement has taken place in job. This would also give a sense of satisfaction to the employee, as his end product would be more significant when compared to the end product in the earlier, which is the shorter cycle. This again would help the employee understand the various process in the organizational working. The organization benefits from enhanced performance of the employee. This is what the job enlargement is also one of the technique of job analysis. Number three is job enrichment. Job enrichment is the most popular technique for you enhancing employee motivation, what I said in the previous session and also in previous where I am discussing about job rotation. We need little bit of, not only little bit, there is that type of atmosphere must be created by the human resource manager to motivate the employee, where there is a job enrichment will be created easily. Organization which employs workers with high level of skills and knowledge should consider implementing job enrichment programs. Job enrichment is done by redesigning jobs as to increase both their scope and their depth. The incumbent has enough autonomy to plan, organize and then control his job. There is less supervision and more less evaluation involved in carrying out of job. Job enrichment is one which is basically caters to all the job characteristics mentioned in the job characteristics approach. Where there is the job characteristics approach will always to make job design. Job enrichment of one job also alters the job supervisors and co-workers. The support and commitment of the top management is extremely essential in an initiative like this, which would be involve a complete change of work culture scenario in the organization and also in the company, either that company organization is situated both in public sector and private sector respectively. Managers who are used to supervising the workers also need to train the counseled to adopt the new style of working, which involves a reduction in their power and to control. They also should be trained in providing timely and productive feedback to the employees. The employees also need to equip to handle the enriched job independently. This is what the things could be, that there is a power and control should be reduction over the control of initiative has to be taken by supervising the workers are counseled, adapted to new style of working only through job enrichment, which is also one of the technique of job analysis. And the last one is work design. Work design, or you may call it as job engineering. Work design allows employees to understand and appreciate the linkage between work methods, layout and handling procedures, as also the interaction between people and machines. Job design was a central issue in Taylor's model during 1815 that this model is appeared to prepare a proper design under job analysis, particularly we known it as a what you call work design, particularly where there is a scientific management is happened. His perspective on the importance of job design is an excellent example of a rational approach to scientific management practices, and also which shows how certain perspective focus more on productivity than on satisfaction. Taylor's recommendations emphasis on the need for scientific job analysis, where arranging work in such a way that workers turn out to be efficient, recruitment be linked one-to-one with job description and job specifications. Continuous need and also based the continuous need based training to employees, and above all employee compensation should be linked to perform the performance, be used for rewarding the performance. As far as a job engineering or if the work design be concerned, the job engineering analyst is expected to example of job design factors by using time and motion studies, determining the time required to perform various tasks and the movements needed to perform those tasks efficiently. These are all the four techniques broadly used to analyze the job. This is how a job engineering analyst is examine the job design, where there is a n number of studies has to be taken up to determine the time required, time element concept, where it will be required for to perform various tasks and movements needed for the task ahead according to the workforce given by the organization and in the company, either it may be in the private sector or in the public sector respectively. With this, I will stop here the techniques of job analysis, because there are a lengthy lecture that I am giving in through making video. These are all in the last slide I incorporated the source of reference, that is Dr. S. Ganesan, that I already mentioned, Leon C. McGinson, and the last one is Human Resource Management, written by Geet S. D. Deshpande and then Deshpande Smita, particularly during 2009. With this, I will stop here. I will come up with a new topic in the next session. For me, bye for now. Thank you very much.